Everybody. Okay, today we're going to take a little bit of a look at some technology that comes with the Samsung S3, but most people won't really have looked at it in any great detail. It's called NFC, Near Field Communication. You'll have heard about this on things like your Visa cards and MasterCards that now have contactless payment, so you just pop your card on top of a reader and it bills you automatically for small purchases. Well, that same technology that can also be used for making payments via a phone, so you can just pop your phone onto one of those readers, it can also be used for storing your own information, and then so your phone can scan the tag and do actions, whatever you happen to like it to do. So you could create an NFC tag which turns your Wi-Fi on and off. You could create an NFC tag which updates a database on the web, saying you've checked in somewhere. You could make an NFC that does Foursquare log check-ins, sends a status update to Facebook, whatever you want. The kind of the world is your Oyster card, as it were, which, funny enough, also uses NFC. For those of you in London, or Russia, I think, also uses the same technology on their underground. New York, guys, tell me, do you use contactless payment systems in New York subways? Bit of NFC? So anyway, NFC comes in a few different sizes. Now, you might think of sizes as being the actual physical side of the NFC chip itself, but actually, it's all down to the amount you can store on them. Some of the chips can store substantially more memory, more information on them, than the other chips. So, for instance, these ones hold about 46K, 42K, I think, on these. And on these ones, you get about 56. There's also some other types as well. For instance, here's NFC built into a wristband. Really good for clubbing and things like that. You'll start seeing these popping up quite often for concerts, I think, more than anything else. But yeah, it all comes down to how much information you're going to be able to store onto each one to suit your project. In most cases, these ones, the round stickers, what's known as bullseye NFC chips, these tend to be the most flexible. Around 56K, I think, you can store onto them. And that allows you to store a reasonable size bytes. Christ, if I could store 56K, we'd be laughing. No, 56 bytes of information. You're sort of talking about 56 characters, essentially. So, you know, you've got to be careful of what you store onto them, how much data you're putting on there. But one of the easiest things to do is to use an app. So there are already some apps available which allow you to create the NFC commands, as it were, that can run on the phone. This particular one, NFC Task Launcher, has an option which allows you to compress the NFC command that you're the command that you're putting onto the chip to save space, but it can only be read back by your phone. It's basically some compression. What we're going to do is we're going to build a tag to turn Wi-Fi on and off. Create a new switch, I assign a task, new task, Wi-Fi, and you can see in here I can do Bluetooth on and off, I can select a particular hotspot, switch Bluetooth discovery, airplane mode, auto-sync, GPS, there's loads of options in here. It's Wi-Fi on and off, and it's a toggle, okay, and we'll just add that one onto there as well. So what will happen is we're going to load this onto one of these bullseyes. I'll just take off there. Pop that on there for a second while I do this. Actually, that won't work. I'll just use this piece of card. So, there you can see is the NFC. We're now going to place it underneath the phone. You can hear the pip, and it says the tag is written successfully. Now, if I just come back to my home, and I'm just going to zoom in now so you can just see what's going to happen up at the top. Keep your eyes on the taskbar at the top. Toggle Wi-Fi. You see there it's flicking the Wi-Fi on and off. Oops. Get that back in focus. So, for instance, what I have is an NFC chip sat downstairs at my door. As I go out, I scan my phone against the chip and it turns my Wi-Fi off on my phone. It saves me battery. Likewise, if I wanted to, I could string a few commands together and I could set it so that it turned my Wi-Fi off, dimmed my screen brightness, boosted my brightness, turned Bluetooth on for my headset, whatever you feel like. NFC is really, really flexible. It's going to be a massive boon for businesses especially. You know, if you've got one of these particular ones, like an NFC symbol chip, printed one, what you can do is set this up in your store, put a little marker underneath it saying check into Facebook. As these phones become more and more popular over the next year, NFC is going to be in every major phone release. Expect to see it in the iPhone 5. There is no way Apple can leave it out at this point. You know, look out for these little NFC symbols. If you've got a phone with NFC built in and you can read them, use it to scan it, see what data's there. You might find some interesting surprises. NFC can also be used for phone-to-phone communication as well. So you can use it to set up things like an ad hoc Wi-Fi connection between two phones for exchanging data, use it for exchanging contact information or smaller packets of information quickly. You literally just take two phones, hold them together, and exchange data. Really, really quick and useful. NFC is not only going to change the world, it already is changing the world. If you've got NFC in your phone, if you've just picked up the Samsung Galaxy S3, go and give it a try. If you want to buy some of these chips, by the way, some of these various chips you can get starter packs online for around $20 to $30. British pounds, you're looking around £20, £23. You'll get a nice bundle, basically. Few of these to try out, basically. You know, get some ordered, have a play with them. The technology is really, really clever, and it extends the use of your phone into a new area that most people won't have even thought of before. A way to wow your friends.